been made in the first place.
Absolutely. It never should have been made. And that is what I do want people to keep track of in your mind when this decision comes out and when these sports are likely brought back. Do remember that Stanford had the audacity to cut them in the first place, and that this is not a heroic story of Stanford bringing on more sports, of providing more opportunities for more student athletes. This is a story of a bunch of student athletes who had their hearts ripped out from their chests, and then they were partially sewn back in a few months later. But they've gone through months of hell fighting tooth and nail to get their back. That's the kind of responsibility they never should have had to take on in their time on the farm. That was not part of the expectation. And, of course, I think the fact they're getting a lawsuit as well from some of the parents of these sports is significant. I think, you know, Stanford never wants to be on the wrong end of a lawsuit or a situation where they're going to lose money. But, again, that's another example of the fact that people did not go quietly into the night. The representatives of these sports did not go quietly into the night. They fought this up with a positive outcome for them. And congratulations to Stanford Synchronized Swimming on a fantastic victory that could not have come at a better time. Right after MTL has this meeting with 36 sports strong, and right as the board is deliberating about whether to reverse this decision, one of these sports that you claimed was not competitive enough for your liking went out and won a daggum national championship. And we've seen success from a number of these sports throughout the season. It's so hard to know that this game, any competition may or may not be your last, and may or may not be the last for your sport ever at Stanford. Thankfully, it looks like that's not going to be the case anymore. But the psychological trauma that went into everything these athletes have gone through for the past few months is just something that they can never be undone, and something we can never let Stanford forget about. But again, this is a testament to the power of hard work, of protest, of consistent pressure on leadership, because those are what got this done. This 36 sports strong movement has really emerged in the past few months, but it's been there since that decision came out in July. And I think you have seen, you know, the Twitter pages for Save Stanford Wrestling, Save Stanford Men's Volleyball are bigger than the sports themselves. Like, you're seeing a ton of alumni pressure, this big petition that comes out that honestly didn't have as many signatures as I thought, but those signatures came from very prominent alumni. This was not one that was getting passed around to us. This was one that was going around to former student athletes from a lot of sports. I saw Adam Keefe's name very high up on the list. Turns out, folks, that every Stanford student athlete and every former Stanford student athlete wants these sports to come back. Even the men's basketball and football representatives, who are the ones who are supposedly going to be benefiting from this decision. If we're reading between the lines, the competitive excellence thing was, you know what, we need to become more like Alabama, more like Ohio State. We need to become an athletic department that is focused on the big sports. We're too spread out right now. Our funding needs to go to, let's just probably go with football, men's basketball, and women's basketball. It may be just those three. And yet, even people from those sports recognize, first of all, this is not going to help us. Don't talk about that. And at what cost? Like, even if this was going to help us, it's not worth other people losing their sport. So it was a ludicrous decision. It's hopefully going to have a happier ending. But throughout, it shows something that I have unfortunately noticed quite a bit from Stanford this entire year in its interaction with the students, is that it does not put its students first. And in very few instances is Stanford's first priority its students' well-being. And that's something that's got to change if the university is going to progress through the 21st century with the same kind of success as it's enjoyed since its inception.
And we've seen that in college sports for a very long time, where the students are not the ones being put first. You can see that with anything involved in NIL. But as you were saying, if you look at the people who are signing on to 36 Sports Strong, and you see names like Julie Foudy, Andrew Luck, Jennifer Azey, Corey Booker, Kerry Walsh Jennings, this is a who's who of Stanford alums. And they're saying Stanford made a bad decision. You look at the numbers, you look at these sports, these 11 sports represent just 3% of the athletic budget. It doesn't make any sense. Hopefully, MTL will make it right. Transitioning now to a much